Businesses go through reorganizations quite often, so you'll probably include org charts in a number of your presentations. Instead of using just text to communicate organizational structures, it really helps to use graphics. If your organization isn't too big, you can use smart art to create great-looking org charts in PowerPoint 2013. Let me show you.
Here I have a slide with the names and job titles of the people in our organization. Instead of including this slide with text, I'm going to use SmartArt to make the slide look like this instead. As you can see, this is much easier to digest, and right away I get a good overview of the organizational structure. Let's go back to our original slide. Here I have Smita, my assistant, James, our CFO, Rebecca, our marketing director, Jacob, our creative director, and Christina, our business development manager. I've also included Rebecca's and Christina's teams.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
To convert this text into an org chart, I'll mark the text, right-click, and select Convert to Smart Art. I'll select More Smart Art Graphics, and here I'll select the hierarchy group. I'll select the picture organization chart and click OK. I strongly recommend that you include profile pictures in your org chart. Before I add profile pictures, I want to rearrange the org chart a little bit. First, I want to move Smita, my assistant, so that she's right below me. To do this, I'll mark the information about Smita and cut it by pressing the keyboard shortcut Ctrl X. Then I'll mark my shape, and on the Smart Tools Design tab, I'll go to the Create Graphics section and click Add Shape. Here, I'll select an assistant shape. I'll insert the shape and then paste in the information about Smita again by clicking Ctrl V. And there she is now in the appropriate position. I also want to move Jacob so that he's next to James. To do that, I'll mark the box with Jacob, and in the Smart Art Tools Design tab, I'll click Move Up. To change the balance, I'll also change the direction of the marketing team branch. I'll mark the manager for the branch, click Layout, and select Left Hanging. Now I want to add profile pictures. To add a profile picture, I'll just click the image. Many business professionals today have their profile pictures available on the internet, on the online network LinkedIn. In the Bing source, I'll write LinkedIn and then my name, Ulrika Hedlund. At first, I won't get any results because PowerPoint is only returning pictures that are in the public domain. I'll click Show All Web Results to see everything, since I'm not worried about copyrights in this particular scenario. Now, the pictures show up, so I'll just mark the first one and click Insert. I'll do the same for all the people in our organization. To finish it off, I just want to add a nice design. So I'll go to the Smart Art Tools Design tab and go to the gallery and choose a nice finishing. And there we go, a great looking org chart that I can share with my team.